Hello, basket makers. I'm here as I promised you with my Easter basket videos, and I'm going to be wrapping these. I wanted to show you the details of what I put in them as I showed you me on this side. You guys can see me. I'm gonna bring some more baskets here. As I promised that I will show you the final product so that you're able to generate ideas for your baskets. And as I was saying, I add products that the kids can use, the moms. So this basket here, it's for a young girl, for an adult, and for a little girl too, because it has a lot of toys. But also that you're able to, a mom and a little girl can just take advantage of what's inside, because it's super, super fun for the adults and the kids. As you know, I only paid $23.32 for a lot of the accessories at Dollar Tree. This is another one. This one has the necklace. Okay, look at this. How pretty. Has the bubble bath. So it has two products inside. Okay. I'm gonna be bagging these. And this one has the Skin So Soft Aqua Express. Some Easter eggs, the jump rope. Some more eggs with candy. There's candy inside. And some toys. It has the earrings. I added some earrings. As I told you, you can break up the jewelry sets. If you have like a three-piece set, instead of using accessories from other companies, add them to your baskets, because you want to use up all your inventory. Also, I want to mix up Easter with summer baskets. So I mixed up the Skin So Soft bath oil with the Aqua Express moisturizing gel. And then I added an Easter egg with candy in it. Here's another one, okay? So with the stronger bowls, you can add heavier products. So that, okay, here are my $5 Easter baskets. Okay, so I had some leftover Mark makeup and inserts that I could not sell. So I got really tired of looking at them, as you can see, and I added them to my $5 baskets. Thank you, and thank you. I see everybody is coming in already. Hi, hello, thank you. Yeah, do your baskets all year round. Look at this one, how pretty. Has the mark. Like, if you will be talking about price, for example, the eye makeup remover, I paid $1 for it. The eyeliner I got for free from Avon, and for the sales meeting. When you go to the sales meeting, you get free stuff. This, like I said, I had bought a party kit. I sold most of the makeup, but the little makeup things did not sell. So I added them to the basket. And then these were like $8, I think, for $1. These bowls are $3 for $1. So these are my $5 baskets. These are $5. But if you, you know, if you want to make them more because you add other products, that's fine. I recommend that you add the price of the product, customer price, on sale from the book. So if you see it on sale, like the eye makeup remover, they're $2. And I bought a lot of them at one time. I sell them a lot, so I had some leftovers, and then I put them in here. So you pay $1 plus tax when you're at 50%. You're making money in this basket. Okay, not a whole lot, but then again, look, the $5 baskets are not get rich baskets. They have many, many, many purposes. For example, when you do your open houses, use those. When you do incentives for your customers, use those. I do, for every $25 that they purchase from me, I give them a ticket, and then I raffle them every campaign. You can also sell the tickets. You can sell a ticket for $1, or you can sell 6 tickets for $5. Jessica, how do I determine the price for each basket? It's the customer price. For example, let me see. Okay, when I talk about customer price, this is customer price on sale. It's $1.99 each. So this is customer price. So if you were to do a basket with shower gels, okay, so you add a shower gel and you add a hand cream, which they're also $2, okay, that's a $4 cost already, customer price, minus your commission. So you're making money, you're adding two products, you're making money on, because the items that you're adding to it, they're $4 plus tax. You can also add deodorants, shower gels, I already said. But the hand creams, I bought a whole bunch of them at $1.69. So use those, okay? Let me show you other ideas too. These right here, so did that answer your question, Jessica? And Rain, did that answer your question? It's up to the products that you add. You have to make sure that you add the cost of the product, customer price, on sale, that you find products on sale to make your baskets, because if you are not giving them a good price on your baskets, then they're gonna go to the book and say, okay, I want you to make this basket because I want to add these products, and then you can move your inventory. Like when I started, I wanted to make money with the baskets, but then the customers say, well, I get a better deal with these products, why don't you make me a basket with the other products? A lot of times I lost a sale at the event, and then I had to go deliver a basket for a customer that I could have given them at a great deal because I used products that were not priced at the right price. So look, this was an incentive. I didn't use this. I didn't have any use for it. It says, I love Avon. And these were rings that I got at the Miami Sales Center. I think I paid like $5, and they had 4 rings, so I separated 2 and 2. And these were $4 for $1. Okay, so any questions? Ask questions, because that's why you're here. It's why it's live. Okay, let me see what else. Okay, so this is the Skin So Soft. It's a body wash. And then I added this bracelet. This would probably go at $15 because of the jewelry. Okay, so here it is. You determine the price. Just make sure that you're not ripping off the customer, please. Okay, look at this one, how pretty. Take the jewelry out of your box, okay? And it'll help display it. And then, see, I put it on Easter eggs. Okay, that's a great question. Look, I get my bags at Uline. You have to be careful with Uline and Amazon because I got stuck with a whole bunch of bags. And even though you can call them, I just didn't want to deal with that. They do return them, but I didn't want to deal with that. So I stayed with them. They're still there. They were not the shiny ones. So these are, you have to call them because they have to be crystal clear. You can get them at Uline or you can get them at Amazon. Sometimes at Amazon you can find a better deal. They have to be crystal clear, resealable shirt bags. This they use to package the shirts. So they has like this, the reason why they call it resealable, because they have this that you can remove. We don't really use it, but it's there. So I use the 12 by 15 and 15 by 18. I use two sizes. And then if I have a bigger basket, what I do, and you have seen me in other videos, what I do, I open this on the side, okay? And on this side here, and I double it up. I open it and I double it up, and then I use two bags. It doesn't matter how big the basket is, you can continue to use these, just double them up. You open them here on the side, right here. You have seen me do that. So, okay. And that saves a lot. I really try to go very inexpensive, because if I raise the cost of the baskets, then that means I have to charge more to my customers, which means that I sell less. So I already have 10 orders for tomorrow for the $5 baskets that I have to finish up. Tomorrow I have an event. It's a fundraiser at Lowe's. So we're gonna be there. Let me bag one of them. Okay, let's bag this one. Do you have any questions? I would like to use a wine glass for a basket. How would I use a wine glass for a basket? I did a video. Go to my YouTube channel, Avon Wings. The playlist is basket making, but if you go to the search channel, you can see, and I'm gonna share it here, baskets using the wine glass from Dollar Tree. And they're very pretty. The only thing that you have to, you can't use big products. I don't know if I should bag this, you guys, because I know that this is pretty simple. You know how to bag this stuff. So I just want to give you more ideas, okay? Check out my pictures for the use of martini glass. Oh, nice. Post them. You post them, Ray? Yeah, please post them. Oops. Okay, these... even though this is looks like a very expensive necklace, I bought a 6-piece. That's for the, I think it was for the 130th anniversary. I sold all the products and then I had two necklaces left. two or one? One. One of these necklaces left. So there you are. Okay. I probably would sell this at 15 because it has a piece of jewelry. But basically, I already made all the money I had to make with the bundle that I purchased. Okay, so I see they're pretty simple. You know, I don't add a whole bunch of stuff to it. Look at this one too. They're pretty standard, okay? Make sure when I tell you to put a nice bow, the bows are one of the most important thing, eye-catching. See, look, even if this is a small basket, you can make your own bows because this will cost you cents, okay? If you start buying the bows that you just put together, that's gonna run the price of your basket up when you can just buy the roll and make your own bow a lot cheaper. Okay, what else? I have another one here made, okay? Look at this. This is a little bracelet. And I attached it to the product. I left a box so that the customer can see that that is an Avon product. Because, you know, that's why I put in the box so that they can see that, yes, it has the quality and the backup of an Avon product. So, and then I have other ones about the same that are about the same over there. So that's your Easter spirit baskets, events. Mix it up with your outdoor bug guard baskets. Have fun at your events. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, Avon Wings. I'm gonna be doing, I already did a live video today there, so I can do live videos with my phone. So I just, you know, pop in to give live videos to my YouTube followers. What's the name of the ribbon that you're using, right? That, okay, so this one, let me see, let me go get it. So I buy these at Costco, okay? They, I think they're $6. It has 50 yards. And you can only get these during the Christmas season. So make sure that if you're buying these during the Christmas, that they are neutral. That you don't have like, you know, jingle bells and Christmas stuff and Santa Claus, that you make them pretty much. Was that what you were asking me? Kind of grieving are you using? Ribbon, right? Yeah. The name of the ribbon. Okay, so I think I answered that. Yeah, please be careful driving. So that's it. You just divide it into three pieces and put in the center the little ribbon, curling ribbon, and that's it. And you have a bow. So simple. I mean, even your kids can do it. So it's going to save you a lot of money. Cents. This is 50 yards. That's a lot, okay? I had this ribbon for like 2 years already, and it just doesn't run out. So, any other questions? Okay. That's it. I think I have covered everything. You guys are very well trained. And you know, I love how you are putting all your pictures there. I love it. I love how you're putting pictures. I want to see videos. How would you use, let me see if I cover all the questions. Leslie, I already answered Leslie and Jessica and Tracy and Ray and Veronica, hi. Okay, so yeah, I answer everybody. So who's volunteering for the next live video, making your baskets? Come on, you guys, we have to have some fun here. It's kind of dead with just me making videos when I know that you can make a video. And once you make the video, save it and put it in your YouTube channel, because you can help a lot of people with what you're doing. I started doing, believe it or not, I started doing my YouTube channel because I wanted to train my team. And I started doing baskets, and then I was like really shy. It was horrible. But then I got used to it, and I got better. Look at this, see? So now that I have a whole bunch of subscribers, almost, I think I have right now like 5,513 or 14 subscribers. And then I didn't realize how many people I was helping. So now, towards the end, as I started making more videos, I recently stopped doing my Wednesday meetings. Now I do my meetings by appointment only when my team wants to get together, because they were telling me that they were watching my tutorials, that I was giving them videos already of what I was talking about at the meetings, and I was already doing that for my representatives who were out of state that did not have me face to face. But they still like to get together, and you know, I set up a time for them to do videos. And I recently got I got several requests. They wanted to use me to sponsor some of their products. They will pay me so that I can sponsor some of them. But I told them, no, not right now. I don't want to be a sponsor for nobody, because I have a lot of work with my channel. I am trying to give you guys as many videos as I can so that you can run your business with confidence, and I'm gonna continue to do them. So I wanna be able to mentor you so you can start doing yours to help your team and help others, because I get a lot of ideas from you guys. Even though I'm not able to see all the videos, it's humanly impossible. But every once in a while, I jump in to support some of you who are doing a Facebook party, who are doing a training, something, you know, I jump in to support you. And I feel proud that you guys are taking the time to connect to everybody. Facebook loves live videos. So start doing your own live videos and mix them up with your business so that you can create the right following on your Facebook. Okay, so that's all I have. See, I gave you a lot of training, so you got a lot of homework to do. Okay, so I think I was too close to you guys, to the screen. That's it. I am going to thank you. I don't know if that means yes, I was too close, or oh, thank you, Elena. Thank you so much. I bought the plastic eggs. Leslie says, I bought the plastic eggs. I'm going to put the lipstick bullets in it. And I have, I'm not sure, around lipsticks. I will put chocolate piece in for my customers. Yes, Leslie, of course. Be creative and add stuff to it, fun stuff. And everybody likes chocolates. You know what? It's a good idea. And they have them at the Dollar Tree. They already have them wrapped for chocolates. You can use they have like an assortment of chocolates that you can just put on your baskets, and they cost $1. Sometimes it's cheaper than just buying them the whole bag at the supermarket. Tammy, thank you. Thank you. You're awesome too. Oh, Marta, Ava Wings. Woohoo! You're the best. Thank you. Chocolate mold. Oh yeah. I actually won this at the sales meeting, and I don't know what it is. I was looking at it at from the Avon Living, and I couldn't find it. So if you guys can tell me what this is and what it's for, because I like to put it on my outdoor basket, but I don't know what it is. So I'm gonna bring it right now. Look, they come in four sets of four. Who knows who this is? I'm thinking that you can use it to label stuff outdoor, but they are made out of they're made out of iron, like metal, that's the word. So what is this? You artistic people, I like to add them to my. I didn't do it today because I did not know what it was. So if any of you can find it and tell me the use of it, I got it for free. So I think that I can put one in each of the outdoor baskets because this looks like an outdoor thing. And it just came like this. So they probably had it as a demo. And you know how they give you stuff at the sales meetings. So make sure you go to the sales meetings because I tell you, you can come out of there with books, with samples, free products, baskets, giveaways. Sometimes we come out with so many stuff. So if any of you know what this is, okay, please let me know so I can add it to my outdoor basket. Okay. See, and it looks like it has like some kind of slots to put a card or something in there. So that's it. See, I gave you a trivia, a mystery question. Okay, so I will see you next in. I'm gonna continue to do videos so you guys can get inspired and do your own baskets. Make sure you share them here. Like I said, do not add a lot of products unless you're doing it for an adult. You can add a fragrance set, and then you can add some candy, some chocolates. Oh, there you go. Yeah, Tammy, thank you. Thank you. Nice. I will look it up so that way I know how to tell my customer. I just don't like to add anything in my basket. I like to talk about it. There's sign plates for herbs. Ooh, it's in the living catalog. I knew it was in the living, but I just couldn't find them. I had no idea, I had no clue. But thank you. So you kind of write the name of the herbs here, and okay, I'll look it over. Thank you so much. See, it was an outdoor item, so I was not wrong about that. Thank you. And that's all. Please don't add any. Add products that make sense because you don't want to add food stuff to skincare. You got my idea. You don't want to. This is fine. This is colorful. This is Easter, but you really don't want to mix up so many colors. You want to stay within the color scheme for all your baskets. Okay, make them nice. If you're not sure if they look nice, please post them here talk to your a family member and ask them. Thank you, Kim. Thank you so much. And then, you know, so that you'll know that they're pretty baskets. Okay, so thank you and have a great weekend. For those of you who are doing events out this weekend, I wish you success. I wish you the best event. Please don't look at results when you're out there. Just work your business. Seriously, be consistent. Do your job, because it only takes one event, one circumstance to just make a difference in everything that you do. Be out there, have fun, enjoy your business. You're working for yourself. Share pictures, do your event on your page so it is public, and have fun. So I will see all of you post here your events, your baskets. I'm gonna be posting my event also tomorrow. It's gonna be great. It's gonna be a fundraising event. So thank you guys. Have a great day and weekend. Bye.